When it comes to a career pivot, you really want to be strategic and intentional to make a successful career pivot. So I'm going to share with you my five pivot tips using my five pivot formula here for you to consider. So the first P is about prioritizing self-assessment. So this is all about understanding you of what's important to you, what you truly want. You want to evaluate your skills, your interests, and your values, and how they align with your overall desired career path. So I always talk a lot about soul searching before job searching. So if you're feeling really stuck, unsure, or if you've been doing something for the same for like the past decade, take the time to do this self-assessment. Now, however, the caveat here is you don't necessarily want to spend like a whole year doing this. You want to give yourself a timeline, let's say either a month or 3 months or so, to go through the self-assessment. Otherwise, it's going to be analysis paralysis. The second is the I, which is all about investigating the market. So this is the external analysis where you want to do a thorough research of really understanding your target industry, the trends, the challenges, or the opportunities. Like what's out there right now? Like what are the hot roles that are in demand? And really understand what does it take to be successful to move into this new role. The reason you want to understand this is really gathering insights and intel. So that's going to give you the right language to you when it comes to position yourself for success. Now, the third piece is the V here, which is all about validating your choices and impact. So this is where you really want to think of and evaluate the potential consequences of the pivot, such as finances, family, lifestyle, time commitment, right? Sometimes when you make a big change, like what's the impact on the other things outside of your career there? So you really want to weigh the difficulty level of making the change against the potential rewards as well, the pros and cons, right? Risk versus rewards. The next is overcoming your fears. So it's so normal and common to have doubts, to have uncertainty, right? You want to recognize these fears and anxieties that you may have of what's really holding you back. And you want to really work on strategies to overcome them. This way, this could be maybe things around self-reflection, getting professional help, or discussing any of the concerns you may have. And then lastly, the fifth is the T, is that you want to tap into your network. You can't do a career pivot on your own. You really want to leverage your existing relationships to get a better understanding and insights and advice on what it takes to be successful in your new career path. Right, you really want to use this chance and opportunity to really understand what could be the potential challenges and understand what are the strategies you need to do to best navigate the pivot. So when you have that intel, it's going to make your transition much smoother and much easier there.